Hello, Mr. Newton here. So we're inside of Warcraft Total War version 2.2, and this is my first online battle, not just in Warcraft Total War, but in Medieval 2 Total War as well. I've never played online before. I played Medieval 2 Total War since 2008, but I've never played online. I've always played single player and hot seat campaigns. Alright, so we're back again. He had problems with crashing. Whenever we started the battle, he crashed. And on my screen, it would just look like it loaded forever. Okay. So usually in Warcraft Total War, due to all the new strat models, you have to play a quick battle first before you can start a campaign. But in his case, he needed to start a campaign first before he could play a custom or quick battle. So it could be the opposite sometimes. I just know that started to happen after I had added quite a few strat models. Okay, unique ones to the map. There's a limit on how many you can have before that bug starts to happen. Had in Game of Thrones Total War as well in the past. Okay. The reason Hyrule doesn't have it is because Hyrule is using the Deskus scripts file instead of the Deskus strat. And for some reason the script file is not the same. It's like the models spawn on the second turn instead of immediately, so the game doesn't react in the same way to the model spawning. Start deployment finally. Waiting for other players to start the deployment phase. Perfect, now it works. Okay, so it was because he crashed. Had some issues. Let's group everyone. So I will group the infantry first. The melee infantry in one group. And one line. And then we will have the archers. The mages in one group. We have loose formation, of course. That wasn't loose formation, that was the double formation or whatever, double line. Okay, we will place them in the center here. Of course we will have fire ammunition on if you can use that. The archers couldn't, not the rangers either. But the sorceresses can, the elven sorceresses. And then there are probably a mage unit too that, it's the bodyguard shit. Doesn't have it. Okay, then we have the pikemen, the elven silver guards. Okay, we have a unit of phoenixes you can place over here. Loose formation and circle and shoot. You should always use the circle and shoot ability with the phoenix and any other mounted cavalry unit that is flying, like the Vion riders or the bat riders. They do better when they have the circle and shoot, and they will fly around in a circle. Otherwise they will usually just stand still and shoot and then enter in melee battle. But when they use circle and shoot, they will fly around in a circle and then they will fly away when the enemy gets near, which is very good. Okay, so I need to hurry up. I need to place some cavalry on the sides. We have the Hawkstrider knights, and then we have the Dragonhawk knights. We can place them over here. And we have the Pyrestar demolishers. Let's place them over here. And the pikemen will be separate. So let's see here. Do I need to group them? We have the Arcane Guardians too. Yes, they are infantry, but we can treat them like cavalry. Okay, they are good against cavalry despite being infantry. Start the battle. So, he has the upper hand. So both started with 75,000. He clearly has the upper hand in this battle. He he might have taken or chosen more elite stuff than I did. So the mages are very good, but they can't kill an entire army on their own anymore because they have a limited number of shots they can fire. They have limited ammunition. I nerfed them. That's why they won't be able to win on their own. Like in the past, we can't use the put group under AI assistance in multiplayer, unfortunately. That would still have been too easy for a player to deal with. Players are usually better than the AI, so... Okay, even on the very hard difficulty. Okay, waiting for other players to end deployment phase. We have the pikes here protecting our infantry and archers. We have cavalry on the sides. Problem is, I'm used to pass the game and then issue orders, but against a player I can't do that. So I will need to be very fast in issuing orders and play out zoomed. Usually I like playing in zoomed in view like this, but against a player I need to have it out zoomed most of the time so I can see what is happening. Let's use the CTRL Q as well, feature of the tool, so I can see where every one of my units are. Now I see that it will blink green with my troops here, and red with the enemy troops. Allied troops would be blue. Okay. So, now we can issue orders. So here we have Forsaken. Interesting. So he has goals there. Problem is, I don't want to send them. Let's see here. What do they have? Infantry. Infantry. Lots of infantry. Out the casters first. And let's have some. Want to know what that unit is. Cavalry. Okay. Let's charge their cavalry there. On this side, we need to make sure they don't have any nasty surprises with cavalry there. Yeah, the upper ground, that's not good. The upper ground. These are cavalry units. Charge with my... Actually, they can charge the abominations instead. They charge with our ordinary cavalry against his cavalry. I need a better overview. This is not good. So we have goals over there. So let's charge with our phoenixes. Our foolish general has thrown his light away, and perhaps our chances of victory with it. We lost the general there. Okay, reversed infantry unit. Could attack their goals over there. Abominations are attacking.
I pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain.
He is clearly leading the battle. Fuck, he's hitting with the mages there. The giant is already taken out, and the phoenix too. Yeah, my army was like weaker from the start. He had too many banshee casters. He used three of them, but his casters were way better than mine, because they were many. Well, mine were kinda sucky. They are good if they have a good position, but we started with a worse position. He was on a hill, so he could hit my troops while I couldn't hit here his. So that sucked. We need to replay this.
Of this battle changes because
it's my first online battle. I'm a total noob against other players, but also his army was stronger from the start. We saw that when we checked the balance of power, that his army had the upper hand from the start. It would have been more fun if no one had any casters. Okay, because my casters got taken out and didn't do any good in the battle. I believe it's because he had the upper ground. Fuck, he's taking out my rangers now too. I don't know what my pikes are doing. I thought I told them to attack. My blood trade should attack their infantry. Total numerical advantage. This wasn't even fun. That's because I don't like playing with limited money, because the factions are not balanced when it comes to costs and such. I think we should just allow each side to have 20 units each. That's why I always play. Otherwise you end up with one player having much better troops. Because he can get an entire army for the same price, I can only get a fraction. The prices may be too high for many of the units of the Blood Elves. They might not at all be as they should, because money is not an area where I'm good. Let's just say that I think that the prices may be too high for many units. When his army was totally overpowered from the start, because the prices of the Blood Elven units are much higher, but the units are not as good as the prices say they are. They were way weaker than what you would think. Yeah, we need to just let everyone have unlimited resources and choose 20 units. But then limit the number of casters. No fun if the number of casters are too many. I think it's enough if we have at the most one caster.
I pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain.
Also, these count as casters too, the Dark Rangers. They have a caster attack. Okay, man. Fuck that.
Lord, preserve us! We have been dealt a stinging defeat today.
What? Alright, Mr. Niren here, so it's time for the second multiplayer online battle in Medieval Total War Kingdoms. My second online battle ever. Okay, we are playing Warcraft Total War version 2.2. Start deployment. Waiting for other players to start deployment phase. So I'm playing as the Sindori or Blood Elves, and he is playing as the Darkiron Dwarves. Of course, in custom battle, a player of the Darkiron Dwarves can also use the Khaz'Modan Dwarves. Their units, so he might have an army of both. Okay, and I'm not sure if we had any. I believe we also have some mercenaries on, maybe, so you can also have the Frost Dwarves, maybe, and Gnolls, I don't know. Okay, but anyway, we let both of us have maximum resources this time, so we have two entire armies, 20 units in each army. Of course, when we use the maximum amount of money, that will lead to both players using only elite troops, because we don't want to lose, so using any sucky troops would just weaken our army. So I'm using an elite army. We had limits on the casters and giants. We can only have 3 giants max and 3 casters, but no limit on archers, on infantry and on pikemen, and we could have 3 cavalry units. The golems are infantry, so they didn't count. Okay. And they are smaller giants. Okay, let's group our infantry first. One line. And we can remove that blinking for now, so we can see what is happening. Okay, I think would be good if we had one line, and then we will group our mages into one group, so we have 3 mages. All of them are the best one, because I don't want to take any risk. Usually I prefer using many different versions, but what the fuck, I wanted that to not be in use. Okay, blinking feet. What the fuck? My game just bugged out. My keyboard bugged out, I mean. Fuck. It's old. It's from 2002. Okay, so the button got stuck there. The button to the left. The left directional button. Okay, let's group the cavalry. The infantry will have in one line, and then we will have the rangers, I mean the mage unit, loose formation, they can be placed there. We have the rangers, place them too, loose formation. Where they are in one line, and then we will have the cavalry on the sides. actually can do this now, so I know where they are. Okay, the cavalry. Fuck, I clicked the wrong button. Cavalry, okay. Okay, and Phoenixes will be in loose formation with circle and shoot ability on. And Firestar Demolishers be on this side. The pikemen, let's group them one line, and then we have some cavalry units, ordinary cavalry. Let's place the blood knights to the right, and the dragon hawks are also there. The dragon hawk riders or knights, hawk strider knights on the other side. Okay. I guess it's time to start the battle. I want to see his army. Iron Star shooters. Okay, we'll send one unit of rangers against that unit of shooters. Some gnomes too. Yeah, he mixed the Darkirons with the Khaz'Modan faction. It's possible in custom battle, not in the campaign. Okay, so we have attacked one ranger. I'm a total noob against players. Oh, the steam tanks are silver surfers for the Darkirons. That will need to be fixed. I didn't know about that. It would look fine if you played as Khaz'Modan or the humans, but not the Darkirons. I forgot to add the ownership line there, I believe. Okay, seems he is just waiting for me to move. Okay. Against the tank, I can move forward the Phoenix. The tank is overpowered in melee. Best thing is to take it out with a ranged attack. He's already taken out. One of the three phoenixes have been taken out. There, he took out that one too. All my phoenixes are dead. I don't like that he has tanks. It's overpowered. This mod is not balanced for multiplayer. It's intended for single player, of course. Okay, so factions might be totally unbalanced against players. He also got the upper ground, which isn't good. I suck against players, because I can't pause and get an overview. come out with my mage. Fortunately, he will kill some of my rangers. I can hardly see anything. Not going too well. He will take out my mage. Remaining here. I start demolisher, blood mage. It's really hard to micromanage in real time. I'm used to just pause the game. Okay, let's retreat. Jesus Christ, I'm losing the good unit over there. And I'm clicking the wrong button. Let's move back my Arcane Guardians. They are valuable. Just fire at will with the mages. Okay. So I do some good. That one should stop firing. He's not hitting anyone. Back all my casters that are still numerous. Okay, what is that? Stormpike chargers. Let's move back with them. I don't want that cavalry unit to take them out. back. He's taking out my blood mages. It's not good.
Protect us. Our general lies slain upon the battlefield.
General died. Not good. To find their guy and stuff, they might have some giants left. Stormpike chargers. They're sending our Silver Guard pikemen there. Firestar demolishers. Darkiron death rocket. Griffon riders. Stormpike chargers. Do they have any giants still remaining? It's hard to see in this forest. That's a bad choice for a battlefield. It's the Kael'Thas battlefield. I thought it fit that faction. But it's hard to see.
Unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory. Only half the enemy force remains.
Warlocks, sharpshooters. I just want them to attack the warlock. Okay. Here we are attacking cavalry. Fighting their stuff here. We are leading the battle, which is very good for now at least. Oh, we only have one caster and he has no ammunition left, or they have no ammunition left, they have more than one. Okay, let's attack there with our Firestar Demolishers. Got the Warlocks with the Blood Shades. We can.
Lord, preserve us.
We have the Griffin Riders. Okay, here they are fighting Stormpike Chargers. What do we have here? Stormpikes, Elven Rangers, possible connection problems. Fuck, he got some problems with the connection. Good game. Ah, it fixed itself, I think. So this is the finale. So Blight Shades aren't the best elite troops, but they are nice to look at. I needed to have them in the army. No point playing the Blood Elves otherwise. Okay, so our pikemen are fighting their cavalry here. They seem to be losing, actually. And the Pirate Demolishers against their cavalry there. We are over here. Okay. And Silver Guards are facing their cavalry too. So here are our infantry. We have an infantry unit there. Tactic now, make warriors with them. These guys too. Attack the other one. Attack the Shadow Sworn Warlocks with the Blood Shades, they are fast. Okay, pikemen also did a good job, but I've lost almost all the Blood Shades now. Yeah, I lost all of them. Here I have a lot of Iron Star sharpshooters. Let's attack them with the Rangers. Rangers versus Sharpshooters there. Forward, pikemen, tactics, cavalry units. Chargers there. No warlocks left, I hope. Then we can attack the cavalry with the Pyrestar demolishers. For the Griffon Riders, they're even more dangerous. Okay, so the battle is pretty even. We have killed 96%, we killed 88%. Has been lost on both sides. Seems like I'm winning the battle. She managed to take out the core hounds. That's interesting. We're afraid of those guys. They can fire when moving. While moving. The Griffon Riders are very strong too. So our Rangers are over here. We have one still alive. Okay. 98% enemies killed and 88% allies killed. We are leading with 10%. I won this battle, I think. Oh, it crashed for some reason.